I continue the lecture one, kinematics. Today I will talk about the straight motion. So firstly, let me remind a bit about the position vector, velocity, and acceleration. So when you want to analyze the times of motion, so you have to base on three these quantities to write some formulas. For example, based on acceleration, you go in the opposite direction, you calculate the velocity, and then when you have a velocity, you can calculate the position vector. So that means from R to V, from V to A, so you go by one direction. Now you go in the opposite direction to find the expression for V based on A, R based on V, like this. And in this case, you have to consider acceleration is a constant. In this, so based on that, you can find the expression for V based on A like this. And when you have a V, you can calculate the R based on V like and A like this. This one is the result and the proof. I will do it in the next slide. I suppose like this. When always remember, A is a constant. A is a constant. We know that A is acceleration. It represents the change of velocity with respect to time. So you take the this one is the instantaneous acceleration. You take the derivative of V with respect to time, because from here you can do the integration by this way. You move dt to this place, and then you take the derivative. Do the integration here and there, and then you see at the moment t equals zero, so you have initial velocity is Vy. At the next moment t, so you have a final velocity is Vt. And then here A is a constant. You can move it out from this integration sign, and then you do the integration, so you have this expression. And when you have velocity, you can calculate the you can find the expression for a position vector. Remember that if you want to calculate the velocity, you take the derivative of position vector with respect to time. So here you move dt to this side, and you do the same like you do with the acceleration. You do the integration here and there, and then you see don't move vt out from the sign of integration, because the vt depends on time. So you have to write it right here, and then you do the integration. So you have a vector position here, and here is the result if acceleration is a constant. So you can calculate the velocity by this way, the position vector by this way. This one, rewrite of this one, nothing special. So here I write the time, and then the velocity, and then the initial position. Here I write the initial position first, and then velocity, and then acceleration. So actually this one and this one is almost the same. So here the example, I suppose that we have a car. At the initial moment, the velocity is 80 kilometer over hour. After a while, so it decreases the velocity from 80 to 60 kilometer over hour, and the distance during the distance is 50 meter. And we consider the acceleration is a constant here, t here, please, I'm sorry for this, a constant acceleration. So remember, if acceleration is a constant, if acceleration is a constant, so we have a two expression for V and R like this. Here is V, here is R. If you consider in XYZ system coordinate, so here V, F here is final, I here is initial. So you can consider VF in the component. It will be VXF, VYF, and VZF. Here also in the component of XYZ. And here you have, if you write in component, so you have X, Y, and Z, the same for this one and this one. In this case, we consider the motion of a car along one axis. You consider that one is OX, for example. So you don't need to write vector anymore. You write the expression for V is like this. For R, it's just the X. So when you have it, if you want to calculate the acceleration, you take a look. Now you have to pick which formula you will use. Take a look on the first formula. You have you need to calculate A, but you don't have a T. One question, but one formula, but two unknowns. So you cannot solve it. One equation, but two unknowns. So you cannot solve it. And take a look here, the second expression of R of X. So you see here T and A, so you cannot solve it. You cannot find A because you have a time here you don't know. So in this case, you have to combine them together. You get the time from the first equation, and then you put in the second equation, so you have this result. Take a look on the result. You see, you have a final velocity here, 60 kilometer over hour. You have an initial velocity here, 80 kilometer over hour. And the distance you need to decrease this velocity is 50 meter you have here. So here is one equation, one unknown is A. So you can calculate the acceleration by this way. So you put the number here and there, so you have a result like this. Take a look on the result. You can evaluate the result. Acceleration is negative. That means the velocity of the car is decreased, and like that. That one. That's all for the acceleration, for the straight motion. Thank you for watching. See you next time.